Okay students, shall we recall some points in 13th lesson? Who said the 20th century is the age of extremes? Eric Hobsbawm. What incidents occurred in the 20th century? I said First World War occurred, Second World War occurred. After First World War, League of Nations. After Second World War, UNO, the peace organization started. Okay, next one. How many countries participated in the First World War and Second World War? How many people died? How many people wounded? Next one. What are the main countries? Axis powers countries, allied power countries. For example, Axis powers countries: Germany, Japan, Italy. These are the Axis power countries. Allied power countries: England, France, USA, USSR and China. So these are the allied power countries. So these two groups fought each other. So finally, at initial stage, Axis powers countries getting victory, but at the end of the World War II, allied power groups got victory. What that countries? Allied power groups countries got victory. What are the allied power groups countries? I said Britain, France, USA, USSR and China. Okay, now let us discuss the remaining part of this lesson. Now students, listen. World War II special contest. First, the Treaty of Versailles. The Treaty of Versailles. After First World War, we know the period of First World War, 1914 to 1918. After First World War, immediately the victory countries, they held one meeting, that is peace conference in 1919. So it is called the Treaty of Versailles. How many countries participated in this? 32 countries or 32 nations participated in the Treaty of Versailles. Actually, some big countries are five big power countries. For example, USA, UK, France, Italy, and Japan. So these big power countries, they conducted this meeting. Some countries not invited to this Versailles Treaty or Peace Conference in 1919. What are the countries? Germany, Austria, Turkey. These three countries were not invited to this Treaty of Versailles. It is very, very important, students. What countries not invited? Germany, Austria and Turkey. These countries not invited. How many big countries participated actively? USA, UK, France, Italy and Japan. How many countries totally participated in this peace conference? 32 nations. Okay, next one. In this, actively participated countries, they concluded or they imposed many conditions over Germany, because they concluded Germany was the responsible person for this World War I. So that they concluded. Next one. African colonies in 1880, Alsace and Lorraine, France, they belongs to France, 1871. These Germany were surrendered what colonies occupied in Africa continent, and also the important place which are belongs to France, these also surrendered to France by Germany. They concluded these two. Pull down army strength from 1 lakh, from 9 lakhs to 1 lakh. They imposed many conditions over Germany. In this, first, Germany were asked to surrender African colonies in 1880. And also, Alsace and Lorraine, which are belongs to France in 1871. Next one, they imposed their military strength from 9 lakhs to 1 lakh. That means they reduced their military strength from 9 lakhs to 1 lakh. Next one, the League of Nations. After First World War, one peace organization started. What is that peace organization? The League of Nations. In 1919, after the Versailles Treaty Conference, they started this peace conference. 1919. Where the headquarters locates this League of Nations? Switzerland, Geneva. Who was the architecture of this League of Nations? Woodrow Wilson. So Woodrow, his mother name, he liked his mother, that's why he named by his name Woodrow Wilson. Next one, some countries are not members in this League of Nations. What are that countries not members? Russia, USA and Germany. Actually, listen students, Woodrow Wilson belongs to USA, but USA was not the member of the League of Nations. That is why Nixon, at the peak position in 1934, actually started in 1919, but it was the peak position in 1934, the members, 58 members. How many members are there in League of Nations? 58 members. What are the main activities or what are the main aim of these League of Nations? Collective security is the main aim of this League of Nations formation. Collective security. Next one, settle the disputes through negotiations, not quarreling each other, not declaring war each other between the countries. But if any dispute will occur between two nations, they will settle these disputes through negotiations. That means talking. Next one, it has international agencies. It started this League of Nations, international agencies. What are that international agencies here? ILO, International Labour Organization. WHO, World Health Organization. ICJ, International Court of Justice. Actually, at present also, WHO warning and giving suggestions about coronavirus. What is the features of coronavirus? And what we have to take the measures to defend to this coronavirus, etc. So WHO, World Health Organization. ILO, International Labour Organization. ICJ, International Court of Justice. These agencies belong to League of Nations. What are that? League of Nations. Next one, Hitler. We know Hitler belongs to Germany. So he joined the Nazi party. Actually, Nazi party was a small party, but when Hitler joined in Nazi party, it got so much reputation because he is an orator. So many people inspired by his speech or lectures. Next one, he wanted to recover the territories after League of Nations, after Versailles Treaty. When the Versailles Treaty imposed many conditions over Germany, but under the leadership of Hitler, he wanted to recover the territories which are lost by the Treaty of League of Nations or Versailles Treaty. Next one, massive army and armament industries. He started many armament industries. He produced many armaments. So when he produced armaments, powerful weapons, he supplied to the other countries. In this way, he earned many huge profits. So this country became rich under the leadership of Hitler. So now he wanted to recollect or recover the territories which are lost. So that is about Hitler. Next one, the fear of socialism and the USSR. Actually, we know what is the meaning of socialism. Socialism means all are equal in the society, irrespective of their region, sex, etc. But listen, USSR, we know what is the meaning of USSR. Workers, socialism and communism. Many workers participated about the socialism in our areas. Especially, it can be seen in USSR. Next one, Russian Revolution occurred in 1917. So they announced that one is communist state. So this Russian Revolution, in the upcoming lesson we will discuss about the Russian Revolution, how it occurred, how they terminated the Tsar, the last Tsar Nicholas II was terminated by the revolutionaries. Next one, USSR, 1924 it started, the meaning Union of Soviet Socialist States. USSR means what? Union of Soviet Socialist State. Next one, when the communism started or prevailed in Russia, when the Russian people terminated the King Tsar in 1917, they declared their state is USSR in 1924. Next one, Britain afraid the spreading of communism in other states. So that's why this Britain went to Germany. So here Germany leader, we know Hitler. So they asked Hitler to stay neutral. So this condition is called appeasement. What it is this condition? Appeasement. But Germany and USSR non-aggression pact in 1939. But this Germany, Hitler did not stay as neutral, which is said by Britain. Immediately Germany went to USSR and they cooperate each other with non-aggression pact in 1939. Next one, Germany versus Britain and France. Next one, Germany attacked on USSR in 1942. Actually, Germany went to USSR, but it was failed. That's why this Germany attacked on USSR in 1942. So we know this is the beginning of Second World War. So we know the period of Second World War, 1939 to 1945. So during this Second World War, what happened? Japan also attacked on USA. So Pearl Harbor belongs to USA. So Japan attacked over Pearl Harbor, which is belongs to USA. That is why USA declared war against Japan. That means USA also participated or joined in the Second World War. Actually, they are the consequences. Next one, what are the remaining consequences of the World War? Enormous human cost. Due to the First World War and due to the Second World War, many people died. How many people died? 10 million people died due to the World War I. 20 to 25 million people died due to the Second World War. Next one, nuclear and chemical weapons used in the World War I and II. That is why we faced enormous destruction. The property lost and human also lost. Almost all countries. Next one, democratic principles asserted. World War I. What happened World War I? What happened World War II? So after World War, that means after 1918, so we saw peace conference held, that is called Versailles Treaty. After they started one peace organization, that was League of Nations. But listen, Austro-Hungarian empires, Russian empires, German empire ended. This is, students listen carefully, these three incidents occurred after World War I. Very, very, very important. What happened after World War? Empire system ended. What are the empires here? Austro-Hungarian empire ended. Russian empire ended. German empire also ended. So I said a few minutes ago, in Russia, 1917, one revolution occurred. So they terminated their Tsar Nicholas II, the last Tsar of Russia, and they announced their state was communist state. That
can be seen after second first world war. Next one, Germany. Weimar Republic started in Germany. This is also very very important after first world war incident. Germany, Weimar Republic, where we can see this Weimar Republic in Germany. Next one, Turkey position. Democratic and secular aspiration can be seen in Turkey. So the Turkey people also revolted against the concerning rulers. Next one, World War II. What happened World War II? Independence in Asia and Africa continent. So we know what are the Asian countries: India, Sri Lanka, Nepal, Burma, Cambodia, Vietnam, China, Mongolia, Indonesia. So these are all Asian countries. These all Asian countries before World War II captured by European countries. Next one, Africa countries. So we know what are the African countries: Nigeria, Ethiopia, Somalia, Zimbabwe, Zambia, South Africa, Libya, Egypt. So these are the African countries. So African countries and Asian countries got independence after World War II. So we know the World War II period, 1939 to 1945. So we know what was the period of independence of our country, 1947. That means after Second World War incident.